So, hello guys. So now we are going to discuss about degrees of freedom. So degrees of freedom is the minimum number of independent parameters required to completely specify the position and orientation of a body. So as an example, I have taken a point on XY plane. So it has only two parameters required, like X parameter and Y parameter, right? To completely specify where the point is. The X and Y are variable parameters, they can change. So you can call it as 2 degrees of freedom, okay? And we don't need the information of orientation here because however the point is rotated, still it looks the same. For example, if I rotate this T, it will become like this, it may become like this, it may become like this. So for this type of bodies, so now it's very clear that for the point, there is no need of orientation to find out the orientation, right? So that's what I was trying to explain. Now, if it comes to a body in space, if you take a body in plane, not in space, in plane, how many degrees of freedom will it have? Let's take that example also. So this is your y-axis. Done. This is your x-axis. Let's try to erase this point over here. Okay, where is your x-axis? Yeah, this is your x-axis. Now, first suppose I have a body in the plane and the body looks something like a rectangle. I'm taking a rectangular shaped link or a body in plane. See this one. Now, to completely specify the position, for example, the center I have taken, to completely specify the position. So I need this axis, x-axis value, I need this y-axis value, right? To completely specify, I need x-axis, I need y-axis. And then I even need the information of rotation because it is free to rotate in the plane itself, staying in the plane x and y, it is free to rotate also. So this has 3 degrees of freedom. This body has 3 degrees of freedom because it needs 3 parameters here. 3 parameters are required to completely specify the position and orientation. So 3 parameters required. So x, y, theta, okay, angle. So that's why it's having 3 degrees of freedom. So you can even say that how many ways can this rotate, can this body move? Being in the plane itself, it can move about X, it can move about Y, it can move about Y, it can move about X, it can rotate about Z. So Z direction is this one. So let's say this, and so it can rotate about Z. So rotation about Z is possible. So Z theta, okay. So there are 3 parameters. So it has 3 degrees of freedom. Now coming to space, now if you take space into consideration, in space, how many degrees of freedom are required? How many degrees of freedom does a body have in space without it connected to any point? See, I'm drawing 3 mutually perpendicular axes. Now I have a body here, a rectangular body. Now, how many degrees of freedom do you think that this body has? How many degrees of freedom does this body have? I'm going to mention it directly here, X, Y, and Z. So I need to know the distance from X, so parameters. I will write down the parameters required. So parameters required are X, Y, Z coordinates are required. Then even rotation about X, so theta X, theta Y, theta Z. It means rotation about X, Y, and Z also are there. So total you have 6 parameters, independent parameters. These are 6. So that's why it has 6 DOF. So a body in space, maximum degrees of freedom possible is 6. A body in plane, maximum degrees of possible is 3. A body in plane, maximum degrees of freedom possible is 3. Okay. It might be less than 3, but not greater than 3. Maximum 3, okay? Minimum can be 0 also. Sir, how can minimum be 0? I will show it to you, see. This is a link, okay? In a plane, it is a link in a plane. I fixed the link in the plane. Over, the degrees of freedom is zero. No need to specify. I'll take the coordinates here itself, reference 0, 0, 0. Okay. I don't need any degrees of freedom. The degrees of freedom is zero. Fine. If the body is moving, only then it will have degrees of freedom. If the body is not moving, if it is stationary, there are no degrees of freedom for that body, and the degrees of freedom is zero for it. So this is all about degrees of freedom. Okay. So it can be rotated, it can be translated, this body in space. A body in space can be rotated about x, y, z. It can be translated about x, y, and z. So that's why you call it, it has 6 degrees of freedom. Okay. I hope you all understood. Thank you.